Vanakkam, Namaste and welcome to Dr. Shah's Clinic. My name is Dr. Shah and I'm a consultant in male infertility and sexual. And today's awesome video, I'm going to give you some mind-boggling facts on sperm motility. Now, one of the commonest questions that I keep getting from my patients is that, dear doctor, what's the normal sperm motility for me to father a child in the first year of my marriage? Now, it's very important to understand that as per the WHO 2010 Andrology Guideline Laboratory Values, the normal sperm motility for a male to father a child in the first year of the marriage should be at least anywhere between 35 to 40%. Now remember, this 35 to 40% is a very rough estimate. In my experience, I've seen men with 80% sperm motility, 70% sperm motility on one side of the spectrum, and on the other side of the spectrum with absolutely no motile sperm, or sperm motility is less than 20% or 10% or 5%. All said and done, just remember that the higher your sperm motility is, the more the total number of sperms in the ejaculate, or the more the total number of motile sperm in the ejaculate, the faster you're going to father a child, provided also that your female partner or your partner is also in the best of health. Now, a very important point that you should bear in mind is that sperm motility can be categorized into three types, and I want you to pay close attention to this part of the video. Now, suppose this is a sperm cell and I'm looking at it under the microscope. If this cell moves from this point A all the way like this to this point B, this sperm is considered a progressively motile sperm. And it's only these sperms that can actively contribute to a pregnancy. Now, there's a second type of motility that you should know, and it's called the non-progressive sperm motility. Now, suppose this is a sperm cell and it moves, and this is point A, but it moves just, you know, around point A like this. That's called a non-progressive motile sperm. And it's highly unlikely that these type of sperms can actively contribute to pregnancy. The last and the third type of sperm motility you should know is the immotile sperm. Now, the more the number of immotile sperms will usually just stay in the same place. They will not even mingle. So you don't know whether that sperm is alive or even dead. Now, what's very important to understand here is that the more the number of immotile sperms in the ejaculate, the more the chances, the more the reduced chance of conception. So when I see men with say 80% or 90% or 70% or even sometimes say 65 or whatever percentages of immotile sperm, the aim of any good fertility treatment would be to reduce the number of immotile sperm and increase the number of motile sperm seen in the ejaculate. Now, all said and done, just remember one thing, that when you look at multiple semen reports, you will see a fluctuation in your sperm motility. And even for a normal man, the sperm motility can range anywhere between, somewhere between 15% all the way up to 80%. And that's exactly why you need to visit an andrologist or an infertility expert with a semen report for a proper evaluation and diagnosis. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I promise to come out with a lot more videos. I would also like to refer you to the top right corner of my screen, where I've spoken on semen volume as well as sperm count. And do like, comment, subscribe and share this video with your loved ones. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Till then, goodbye.